feels the causes of meditation. And those who play never suspect. He doesn't play for the money he wins. He doesn't play for respect. He deals the cards to find the answers. Sacred geometry of chance. The hidden laws of a probable outcome. The numbers lead a dance. I know that the spades are the swords of a soldier. I know that the clubs are weapons of war. I know that diamonds mean money for this art. But that's not the shape of my heart.
Hello, folks. I'm Johnny Norvell with the Music Performance Academy. Today we've got a partial performance and full tutorial on The Shape of My Heart. I'm going to be guiding you through the whole song, the intro, the bridge, how to sing it, and everything. So stick with us here. And if you like what we're doing here, like and subscribe. And we really appreciate all our people that are tuning in. So thanks a lot. Let's go ahead and get started here. Okay, let's go ahead and open up the tutorial now with the chords. So what you've got here is an F sharp minor. It's just like this, and it's a different voicing. So the way you do that, you've got your pinky on the 10th fret on the 2nd string. You've got your 3rd finger on the 9th fret on the 5th string. And you've got your index finger on the 3rd string on the 6th fret. And the chord sounds like this. And now, if you'll play that, get your hands in place, I'm going to show you how to finger pick it. So the way it starts is going to be 2nd, thumb, index, 2nd. So it's like this. One more time. Now the next chord is going to be what they call a D6. And watch how we do this. It's really easy. All we do is move this finger right here, and this one goes down one fret from here to there. It looks like an E7 shape, but it's actually an E6. So in the way the picking pattern here is, it's thumb, second finger, thumb, first, second. So let's go through what we got so far. Do the same. Now what we're going to do is slide down. Everything slides down, and this is a D6, and it's the exact fingering I just showed you. Let's do that one more time. What we know so far. Got that? So what we've got here is an F sharp 7 to an E6, and we go to a D6. And right after that, it goes like this. So what you're going to do is you're going to flatten that out like an A, and it's going to be, see that? That's on the 4th fret. One more time, what we got so far. Got that? Now we're moving on to another chord here. This is going to be a D6 chord, but this is kind of a riff chord. And what it does is it walks into it. It's kind of a problem chord, but it's not that hard once you get the hang of it. So it's like this. Do that again. Do it one more time. We're trying to close up for you so you can see what I'm doing there. And then it goes down here to an A chord with this pinky on the 5th fret on the 2nd string. And what you're going to do is you're going to hammer from here, this note to here. It's a hammer on from an A to a B. And then you're going to pull off. And then it goes to a C7 or C sharp 7 chord right here. And it just does this. So let's do this together. and then it moves up to what we call a D major 7. Hit twice and go to this G minor 11 chord. It's not that hard. What you do is you take, this is on the 4th fret, and you take your 2nd finger, and these are stacked. So this is going to be on the 6th. This next finger is underneath it on the 4th, and the next finger is right underneath it on the 3rd, and the 2nd finger is right here. And then the last chord is right here. Now I think I forgot to show you one part here. When it goes back the second time, or I guess this is the second time through, it doesn't go like this, it goes like this. Everything's the same except this finger moves up. So it's like this. The first time it's like this. So let me play the whole line through and then we'll finish it up. So all the way through what we got so far. Now when it comes back and moves, this finger moves up to the D. See how that did? From here to there. That goes to that riff chord, D6. Then it goes to here. And then to the C sharp 7. Then it goes to D major 7. Twice. Those are all the chords. Okay, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to sing a line. And y'all, I'm going to do it really slow. So the secret to singing this and singing and playing the song at the same time is, it's a little bit difficult. It's like tapping your head and rubbing your belly at the same time because of the way the song goes together. But it can be done. You just have to keep working at it. So here we go. I'm going to sing the chorus here. I know that the spades are the swords of a soldier. I know that the clubs are weapons of war. I know the diamonds mean money for this art. That's not the shape of my heart. All right, we're back to it. What we want to do here is show you the bridge chords. What I'm going to do is a performance. I'm going to do the chorus, and then I'm going to go through the bridge, sing it, and then show you how to get through this stuff solid. So here we go. I'm going to start with the chorus and go right through the bridge. There's no harmonica here, by the way. This is during the harmonica part. So here we go. I know that the spades are the swords of a soldier. I know that the clubs are weapons of war. I know the diamonds mean money for this art, but that's not the shape of my heart. That's not the shape of my heart. That's not the shape of my heart. Oops. Got you through the whole bridge there, and during that part, that's when the harmonica solo is going on. Those are the correct chords. So let me go ahead and go through the chords. We already know the chorus there, so we're not going to go through that again. So when it comes off, it goes right to here. So here's the chords. I missed one a while ago. It starts on the 9th fret, and that is a C sharp minor. It's just a different voicing. See the similarities? So let's get a close-up on that. You've got a pinky on the 3rd string on the 9th fret. You've got the 3rd finger on the 9th fret on the 6th string. And then you've got the index finger on the 6th string on the 3rd. Index finger on the 3rd string, 6th fret. That's the chord. And then what you do is you just move this down to here. See the shape? It looks like an E7. But that's actually a B6. And then you move it down again. That's that's an A6, and what you do is just, that's a suspended G sharp, and then you just take this finger and place it there, and you have a G sharp 7. And you do the whole thing slow. Now you can finger pick that if you want. Now, when you get to there, it's going to be a little riff going here. On the 4th fret with the index. Oops. See that? That's kind of a water chord, kind of a bossa nova thing. And that is an A6. As soon as it goes there, it goes to an E7. And it goes to a G sharp major. And then back to, and up one to A major. And then back to the G sharp major. And watch this, it goes to C sharp minor. And then you pull this finger in pinky and you get a C sharp minor 7. It goes back up to A, back to G sharp. And then what you do, the last chord is right here. And those two are left ringing. I'm going to play the whole thing one time, real slow, and maybe you can follow along. Now let me give you a pointer here. During this, you're doing this a lot. If you'll just go to like an A chord and just do that, you're going to do the thumb and then grab these two with first and second. Just practice that. That's a pointer. Now that's pretty much. Oh, I got to show you the ending here. So the ending is at the very end of the song. It goes like this.
The shape of my heart. That's not the shape of my heart. That's not the shape of my heart.
It ends on that F sharp minor. Okay. Now, I perform a lot of songs, but I also teach a lot of songs. That's what I was doing way before I got this thing, and we're doing this thing online. What I'm trying to teach y'all is to level up. I don't have the greatest vocals, but some of you all have amazing vocals, but you can't match up your guitar. You don't know the names of song or chords. So I'm just trying to teach y'all how to level up so that you can just really increase your game. What I notice a lot on YouTube is you don't see people showing you chords. They just give you tabs or whatever, and it's just real quick. We're trying to do something that's in depth, that's going to move you all a lot farther along. And the material we're going to cover is going to be stuff that maybe a lot of younger people would like to do. We're trying to level things up ourselves. So we enjoy you being here. Go through this video slow, and don't critique it so much. Just go through it, because there's a lot of material here for you guys that really want to get there. And I've been playing for 45 years and I'm still learning. So we enjoy you being here. Like and subscribe, and we'll see you next time. God bless.